friend, and welcome to my channel. My name is Sky. I'm the owner of our online home decor shop called House and Home. And today I am going to be sharing how I have started to decorate my home for summer. So in my most recent video, I shared my summer home decor favorites from Amazon. And today I'm going to bring you into our dining room and share how I have added little touches of summer in this space. I'm going to take you behind the scenes and just kind of share my thought process on how I'm decorating my shelves and my hutch. I'm also going to share a very simple yet beautiful summer tablescape idea. So I hope you guys enjoy this. Make sure you give this video a like and hit that subscribe button.
Okay, friends, this is my summer tablescape idea for you guys. So today is actually my 9th wedding anniversary. My husband actually just came home with these beautiful roses, which was so timely because I had some faux flowers in this vase and was getting ready to shoot this video. And he got here in the perfect timing to swap them out with these beautiful roses. But I just thought that I would share my thought process and how I like to decorate for summer. It certainly does not mean that this is how you need to decorate your home. I want you guys to do whatever makes you happy and feel at home. So this is what I kind of have done. You guys know my style is light, bright, and airy. I love to use whites and natural tones when decorating in my home, and I continue on with that when I'm decorating for summer. I like to add lots of different textures, and I love fresh flowers and candles and greenery. So those are kind of my staples when I'm thinking about decorating my home for summer. I got this beautiful table runner on Amazon. It was actually in my most recent video. I did an Amazon favorite, and I just love the ruffle detail on the ends here. We have a very long dining table, so a standard size table, I imagine that this table runner would kind of drape off of the edges, but I actually love it. I think it's perfect for this space. So then I went in with this beautiful garland that I've had for a long time, you guys. I think it's from Hobby Lobby, so I'm gonna try to find it and link it for you all. If I can't find it, I will certainly link something similar, but I just kind of draped that across my table runner. And then I added some different textures here. So I've got this really pretty basket that is from Target. It's a little serving tray, and I think it's so pretty. I added in a tea towel that I've had for ages. I think that this is from Target. I think it's Hearth and Hand, but you can see it's not even like it's stained, but from afar you can't tell. So I'm using it in there to just kind of separate things up and add a little pop of that black color that ties in with my hutch, which I will show you in just a second. And then I've used our riveted serving tray from House and Home as just like a little separator just to add some depth and some character. And of course, my beautiful roses from my husband. They smell so good. I wish you guys were here and could smell them. And then over here, I have this grapefruit mangosteen candle that is from Sweetwater Decor. We carry these in our shop, House and Home, and this seriously smells like summer in a candle. It is the most tropical fruity smell ever. And even with it not lit, I am just getting so many beautiful, delicious smelling whiffs of this just standing in this room. It is such a perfect candle for summer. And then would you guys look at this little mini cake stand? I am obsessed. It is from the Target dollar spot. I think it was a dollar, and I got a couple of them because I just could not get over how stinking cute they were and thought they'd be perfect for putting my candles on. And then here's our marble tapas board from House and Home. I absolutely love these. I am so happy that our vendor just restocked them. They've been out of stock for like 6 months, you guys, and we just got them back in the shop. I think they're so pretty, to use as decor and, of course, functional at a little gathering. You could put some cheese on there or some desserts or appetizers. I think it would be so cute. So you can see I've got some cream colors here with my flowers and my candle, and then I've got lots of different like whites, and I've got the marble and the pops of green from the flowers and the garland. I love how it turned out. I think it is so pretty and elegant and simple and adds just that perfect touch of summer and pop of color. And if that was too much color for you guys, look at what a difference it makes to just remove that garland from the table. So this definitely offers just a more simple and neutral look. It's definitely a lot brighter and more airy. So that's also an option if you want to go with just more of a simple look. You could come in here with a pretty bowl, or in this case, a colander with some fresh fruit. I think fresh fruit on a dining table is always so pretty, and look at that color that it brings into this space. Now we'll move on to my shelves and I'll share how I have styled them. They are so pretty. I just love adding these different textures here. You will see from the seagrass to the chambray of the oven glove, and then the mango wood on our cake stand. When I am decorating a space like this, I really try to just create balance, and I try to create consistency. So you'll see the wood tones tied in from the brackets of the shelving to the decor that I have up on those shelves. And then the same thing over here on this side, and then with the table and the basket, I'm just kind of tying in the colors all the way around the room to create a cohesive and consistent look. Up here, we have just so much goodness on these shelves, you guys. I cannot wait to tell you about all of these things. So I like to keep my heavier, taller pieces on the top. And then down here, you'll see I'm tying in a little bit of that height with the plate and with these glass pitchers. But overall, I'm keeping things pretty even keel down here. This is a rattan lantern, and it is from our shop. This is one of our newest arrivals. I think this is the most perfect thing ever for summer. It has a little glass container in there for a candle. These could be used inside in a beautiful, like in a sunroom, or even as a centerpiece on a dining room table. I think that would be so pretty. You could also use these out on your porch if you're having a get together and put some candles in there and just enjoy a summer night by candlelight. I think that would be just so beautiful. These actually come in two sizes. So this is the small, and we have a large over on our website. And over here you can see I've just got a plate and then these super cute pitchers. These are from our shop too. These are just my favorite. You guys know that you just cannot go wrong. I love a little creamer pitcher. I think they're so cute. And then up here we've got another one of these pitchers from Target. And then we have these chambray oven mitts, and I cannot get over them. I'm going to show you a close-up here. I love these so much. We had these in our shop when we first opened last July, and they have been backordered ever since. You guys, I didn't even get to grab one for myself. So we just got a huge shipment of these in, and I just cannot get over them. I think they're so cute and they're super great quality. They would make for just a fun little like housewarming gift or hosting gift. I just love them so much, and I'm so glad that we got them back in the shop. And we also have them in another color. They come in kind of like a charcoal gray color as well. So I love that. I just kind of added that here in between my two pitchers to just add a little bit of separation. I love this pitcher. This is stoneware and it has like a terracotta base. That one is from Target. And then our mango wood cake stand with just a little vase on top.
I love these cake stands. Let me give you guys a close up.
This is the Mangowood cake stand from House and Home. I think it's just so beautiful, you guys. This has been such a hot product in our shop. We just cannot even keep them in stock, which we have them in stock right now because we just restocked. So if you want one, go and grab it. It's got this beautiful like ivory enamel top, which I love. It's so pretty. So pretty, you guys.
And then over here, I just created that sense of consistency. So we have another Mangowood cake stand. We've got a Mangowood little cutting board, lots of these white planters. Let's see, up here we've got another Sweetwater Decor candle, another riveted serving tray, and I love this ivory vase. This is one of my favorite items in our shop because it is so versatile. You can use it for utensils, you could use it to put flowers in, you can use it just out for decor, like minimalistic decor, kind of like this. You can do so much. And then these baking dishes are also from House and Home. And I really honestly just love stacking little dishes on my open shelving. I think it's so pretty and it just gives off such a simple and beautiful look.
You can see here that everything is just balanced out so nicely. We're keeping the larger, heavier, if you will, not necessarily in weight, but in how they look items up above on the top shelf, and then just some lighter items on the bottom, but just creating that cohesiveness with the different wood tones and with the mixture of the different whites and creams. Now I wanna take a second to chat about this hutch. We got this used on Facebook Marketplace a couple years ago, and Chad was able to just put a few coats of white paint on it and some new hardware, and it looks like a whole new hutch, and I just love it so much. So my thought process when styling this is usually just keeping it pretty simple and just like light and airy. I like to use glass inside here as well as just mix some whites and creams, a little bit of black pops of color, as well as some greens with the plants. So you'll see I've got this black scale, which I think is so beautiful up here. And then we've got this terrarium. And then up here, hey guys, I've got a little milk frother. And then I've got my Stay True sign, which I love so much. This is new to House and Home. It just hit the site today. And it is handmade by local artisans in Kenya. And it's a woman-owned company. And I just love how they are empowering women and giving women of Kenya opportunities. And yeah, go check out our website to learn more, but it's just such a cool company to be partnering with. So I put that there just to tie in those blacks. You can see that I've kind of just separated everything. We've got some glass down here, glass over here in the middle, and then up here in this corner, and over here, we're just creating balance. And then separating the glass with some pretty whites and creams. So I've got here my Dutch oven, some coffee mugs, and a little plant. Yeah, you can just see I've kind of created just a cohesive look all the way around. This is just how I have my hutch styled. There are so many different ways you can go about doing this. Because mine's in the dining room, I tend to keep it more kitchen centered. So there's a lot of dishes and kitchen items in there. But if I had this in a different room of my house, I would definitely be stashing some super cute picture frames in there, some folded up or rolled up cozy blankets and throws. I would use books for decoration, my pretty home books in there. There's so many different ways you can style a hutch. And yeah, I hope this gave you an idea or two.
Okay friends, that is all for today's video. Thank you so much for watching. Make sure that you give this one a thumbs up and hit that subscribe button so you can see more weekly videos from our channel. We have an exciting decor haul coming next week and I cannot wait to share it with you all. I'll see you next time.